I'm Isabel Fusi, and welcome to the March episode of ITV. Did you know that the Interlochen marketing has thousands of photos that appear everywhere, and about 80% of them are classical music majors? Classical music majors are easy to spot in the wild, and many times you can find them printing sheet music in the dorms, carrying instruments everywhere, some that are double their size, talking about playing in every ballet, and sometimes canceling hangouts because they've got rehearsals.
Hello, I'm Meredith. I'm a second year senior film major and I'm the vice president of ITV. And it's time for spring cleaning! Now don't worry, we're not here to talk to you about doing your laundry or cleaning your bathroom or anything like that. You should probably already know those things. We're here to talk to you about the little things that you might not even think about. First things first, cleaning your surfaces. When you live, sleep, eat, cook, all in the same place, things can get pretty dirty without you even realizing. So wipe those surfaces down. Next is cleaning out your fridge. My fridge is clean, but yours might not be, so you should probably go check those expiration dates. Next up is organizing your drawers. I know there's a big chance you have a drawer that you just throw your stuff into when you don't know where to put it, and it's probably a bit of a mess right now, so it's time to clean it. Lastly, cleaning your mirrors. Tried to take a mirror pic recently and it was less than clean. Well, it's time to fix that. And you may be thinking, Meredith, isn't that just like cleaning your surfaces? No, because if you use a wipe, it's gonna get really streaky, which will still look really bad. So we're gonna do something different. First, you're gonna need some dish soap. Next, you're going to need something wet to clean it with. For me, I have this. Now, you just scrub around.
Then you're going to get a wet towel or paper towel or something and wipe it down. And there you go, a perfectly clean mirror to see yourself with. Use these tips and you'll never fail a room inspection again. Bye!
Reminder that there will be a blueberry hidden somewhere in this episode. And once you find it, make sure you're the first to send the timestamp and your name to Interlochen TV at interlochen.org for a chance to win a free Mofro gift card.
Hi, my name is Katie Dorn, and I am a contemporary dance teacher here at Interlochen, and I am in my fifth year.
Hi, my name is Mika Perrine. I'm an instructor of creative writing here at Interlochen. I've been teaching here for 15 years.
Hi, my name is Claire Collins, and I am an instructor of film and new media, and I started in the fall semester last year.
Hi, everybody. My name is Christine Marie Brown, and I teach in the theater arts department. I'm in my sixth year.
My favorite female artist would be the American postmodern choreographer, Lucinda Childs. Her work is really categorized by her use of conceptual minimalism and spatial exploration. And she really works with what is considered sort of simple, repetitive movements. And I use air quotes for simple because while it may look simple, it's actually really challenging for the dancers. And how she sort of uses diverse permutations of where they are in the space. So she's really well known for her use of minimalism, and I think she, one of the reasons why she's one of my favorite artists is she's 83 years old, and she's still currently making work, still performing, still choreographing. And stereotypically in dance, especially for a female dancer, the career is considered to be very short. And so for me as an older dancer, I find it really inspiring that she still has the passion to keep working. She currently performs, she's an actress, she's a director for opera, choreographer for operas. She's also throughout her career really collaborated with a lot of really amazing artists such as Philip Glass, the composer. She's worked with Frank Gehry, the architect, Solowit, the visual artist, and that's just a few. So I find her to be pretty awesome.
One of my favorite female artists is the Canadian short story writer Alice Munro, who received the Nobel Award for Literature in 2013. And I really love Munro because to me, she reinvents the short story form. I love how she explores her characters through their memories and obsessions and inner associations. And her sentences are just exquisitely crafted. I really appreciate how she makes the ordinary feel extraordinary.
I struggle with the answer to my favorite artist. I think that's a little bit crazy, but one of my favorite female artists is Anastasia Shapani. She is a textile artist and she hand sews these stunning large-scale tapestries. She's one of my favorite artists because she takes a really personal approach to her work and excavates really painful memories from her life and utilizes fabric from those periods of her life. A lot of times it's clothing, her own or clothing of loved ones, and uses them to create these incredible landscapes. And I really admire the way that she takes pain and turns it into something so beautiful.
The person that I probably have the most admiration for right now as a female artist, it was really hard to choose, honestly. but as an actor and a teacher and a director, I'm a huge fan of Viola Davis because she is a classically trained theater artist who worked in the trenches, pounded the pavement in New York, did one of August Wilson's original productions, then won a Tony, then went to Hollywood, and now she's done so many incredible film roles and TV roles. So she's somebody who's done all the three big things you can do as an actor, theater, TV, film, here in the States. But I also deeply admire her work ethic and the way that she talks about her family, both the family of origin that she grew up with and the family she's created with her husband and her daughter. And the fact that that spirit of generosity doesn't just come through when she's interviewed as a human being, when she talks about her work and her life, but I find her just an incredibly generous actor. She gives so much to her partners on screen. It would be a big dream of mine to see her on stage. But that's something that you, most actors take a long time to really learn, that it really is about the other people, not about you, but making your partners look good, responding to your environment. And I find her just so responsive and generous and willing to just not worry about what she looks like, sounds like. And then, of course, because she's brilliantly trained, she's just an incredible technician as well as a generous and generative artist. And I have to give a shout out to one more person because they're a multi-hyphenate in terms of being a screenwriter, adapter, and the only actor to win, I think, for acting and screenwriting at the Academies, and that is Emma Thompson. And she's definitely someone I also very much look up to and aspire to be like. So those are my two, Viola Davis and Emma Thompson. And if you don't know who they are, Google them, go down the rabbit hole, you'll have a really good time.
The sun is coming back out on Interlochen's campus and we are all just waiting to go home. But the projects and performances keep on coming, so how do we keep our energy up during this busy time of the year? Well, we are finally seeing the temperature increase outside, so it's a great time to go on a walk or have a picnic. Another development on campus has been the kitchens, so an awesome thing you can do with your friends is cook some of your favorite foods together. And if the outdoors scares you, well, you can always read a book or do some kind of craft indoors, especially now that the makerspace is up and running in the library.